Test. Here we are, everybody. If you have my cell phone number, you can text me. Shoot me a little message up here. See if we're coming through loud and clear. We'll have some JV matches here in just a few minutes. We got 3 minutes, and we'll run some JV matches at you. So, you got your phone on you, Jordan? Go to YouTube, see if we're streaming. All right, everybody. First Bulldog Nation Foundation streaming of the season for wrestling. First home event. Bulldogs will be taking on the Century Panthers of JV matches here in about 2 minutes. We're getting warmed up. Bulldogs are warming up. Century just cleared the mat. The ref is just kind of waiting for the clock to tick down. Got sound over there, Jordan? Okay. All right. So I'll see if we can con somebody in to come sitting up here. We might get Bulldog legend Brenton Ring up here in a minute if we can. See if he wants to chat us up. Maybe get Heppner over here if we can do that. So the Bulldogs are coming fresh off the Christmas tournament in Rochester. Had a pretty decent showing over there. Bulldogs got a very young team this year. Highlight of the tournament is Marty Prieto coming in eighth at the Christmas tournament. Wrestled a good tournament over there. Placed in the top 10. That's always tough to do. So, all right, hopefully we can get a name on the ref tonight too. But he's calling the coaches over. Bulldogs coach this year, we've had a little change of the guard, not much, just a handshake turnover, I think, to Steve Hendricks is the head coach now. We got Nate Filesticker and Bobby Bedstead, Darren Wingert, Cam Miller, Garrett Miller, Cole Williams, and Jeff Cargill leading the ship tonight. Bulldogs are, here we go. We got ring announcer Paul Arsvold. Apparently we're not going to get very much from Mr. Arsvold tonight. All right. So anyway, we got to tackle cancer. A little paperwork, things that the head table needs to do. First home event. We're early in the season here.
Starting us off this evening, JD from Rochester Century, we have Wayne Meyer, and from Plainfield to Belleville, Logan Peterson.
All right, I don't know if you heard Paul Arsvold or not, but we have Logan Peterson for the Bulldogs. He's an eighth grader rolling out here against Lane Meyer, another eighth grader, both a couple of big kids. Usually, hopefully, what that means is once we get going here, that one or both of these guys will wrestle again. We'll see some pretty good JV action out here tonight. All right, pretty typical action out of the JV kids. Sparring hands a little bit, trying to tie up hands so you can get an inside tie. Logan's on that collar, backs out. Right. There's a nice single leg by Meyer. He's going to take Logan to his back. That's going to be pretty tight. Logan Meyer looked pretty smooth on that single leg takedown. Long time left, buck 10 on the clock. Oh, Logan is going to work his way to his belly here. We'll see if he can get through. And there's the pinfall at a minute 36 for Logan Meyer, eighth grader out of Rochester Century. Logan Peterson learning the ropes a little bit. Got to shake hands after the match, right? Okay. Looks like we're going to see Cooper Mack for the Bulldogs. And he, I would guess. There we go. Lane Royston, seventh grader out of Rochester Century, is going up against Cooper Mack, an eighth grader for the Bulldogs. Cooper has been around the program for a long time. Son of Mike and Bethany Nielsen. Cooper probably pretty happy tonight. It's not very often he gets to wrestle a guy his own size. Cooper's got a big motor, and he's good on his feet. We'll see, get a quick takedown here. We'll see if he can get a turn here. Trying to get that head down. He's cross-facing and chopping arms and doing everything he can. If I remember correctly from last year, I would venture to guess he's trying to set up that cradle. If we can push on that head and get him to duck just a little bit, and Cooper will lock that up and put him on his back. Out of bounds, we'll go back to the center. Lane trying to work back to his feet for the Panthers. Cooper not having any of it. Cooper checks with his coaches. We'll go back to the center. Bottom man set. Top man on. Here we go. Cooper cuts him. 2-1. Cooper Mack. Cooper controls the tie. He's got a little snap down. There's a nice deep shot by Cooper. He's in on that double. Just climb that tree and see if he can finish to his back. He's trying to get the half there. Lane able to get back to his belly. Cooper Mack with a cross face. He's trying to set up that cradle. Drives through the hips to see if he can get that half Nelson. Hard to keep up on the announcing with Cooper. Like I said, he's got a big motor and he keeps going. Right. 11 seconds left. I would venture to guess Cooper will ride him out here. He's going to get him barred up. All right, that's the end of the first. Cooper Mack for the Bulldogs up 4-1 over Lane Royston. Red takes down. All right. Come on, bud. Referee decides we're going to face the other way now. On the whistle, Cooper chops an arm. See if he can get that bar back in there. There he wings that up. I get a feeling Lane Royston might be feeling a little overwhelmed here. Cooper's got an, I don't know what Lane's background is, but I know Cooper's got an awful lot of mat time under his belt. There he's going. He's got that inside cradle heading aside. Getting some back points here. We'll see if he can get those shoulders down. He's got an awful lot of time if he can hang on to it. There's the pin. 2 minutes and 48 seconds. No, that's a lie. 2 minutes and 38 seconds for Cooper. Good job for him. Mom and Dad up here in the stands hooping it up a little bit. All right, we'll go to our third match of the night.
Now wrestling from Rochester Century, Jackson Spearman, and from Plainfield, Millville, Xander Fuller.
All right, so the next match we'll have Jackson Spearman. I don't know if you heard Paul Arsvold, ring announcer. But we got Jackson Spearman, who looks pretty accomplished just the way he's working up front. Working against Xander Fuller, seventh grader for PEM. Oh, Xander got a little half Nelson trouble right there, and there's the pin. In 38 seconds for Jackson Spearman from Century High School. All right, let's see who the Bulldogs bring up next. We're rolling right through them here. I don't think we've had a full match yet.
Now wrestling for the Panthers, Cooper Spearman, and for the Bulldogs, Josh Shaw.
All right, so now we got Cooper Spearman, Sheeran, not Spearman, Sheeran,
in the house yet, but
like
Josh
Ed Sheeran.
Favorite teacher from all the years.
Cooper Sheeran for Century. Josh Shad with a quick takedown. Teacher appreciation night. We got a lot of stuff going on. All right. Teacher appreciation night, and Josh Shad's favorite teacher is one Dave Dieslin, shop teacher, industrial tech teacher, because in Josh's words, he learned that he can have fun and work hard at the same time from Mr. D. We also have a tackle cancer night tonight. You'll see the purple on the coaches and on a few of the players. Looks like over by the door, we got recent Bulldog alumni, one Nate Walbrook, here to watch his Century Panthers in action. So he gets to double dip tonight. He lives in Elgin, but he is currently the principal at Century, so he gets to play both sides of the coin tonight. Josh is working on a butcher here. We'll see if he can get it spun around. He runs the head perfectly. He's got it locked up. It's pretty tight. Short time on the edge of the mat. We'll see what we can get. All right, Josh Shad with the pin. All right, welcome back, everybody. We didn't leave you on the video, but I had to mute for a second. Had a little technical difficulty. We had lost our Bulldog Nation Foundation logo on the bottom right hand of our screen. We got Tucker Benner wrestling for the Bulldogs now. Speaking of the Bulldog Nation Foundation, big shout out to them for all they do for our Bulldog activities in general, whether it's theater, whether it's music, whether it's any sport, all of it. It's all about the kids for the Bulldog Nation Foundation. So anytime you can support them, please do so. If I get a Bulldog Nation Foundation member out there, they can text me the date of that spring fundraiser, the facilities fundraiser. That would be cool. But I know that is on for this spring. The Bulldog Nation Foundation, big sponsors of the PEM, or the Plainview Elgin Millville Hall of Fame, which we had to skip this year in our COVID chaos. So we will be putting in our class next fall on homecoming for that Bulldog Hall of Fame, Bulldog Watchman Gopher Hall of Fame. Benner lasts out the first period. He's down 5-0. Tucker Benner is down 5-0 going into the second. Red Joyce, he defers. Green takes neutral, so Century athlete chooses feet. He's out there in a nice square stand. Tucker must have learned a lesson on that first takedown. He's keeping his feet moving, not really tying up with his Century counterpart here. Tucker Benner in deep on a single leg. We'll see if he can finish here. Century wrestler sprawling and spinning. We'll see what happens here. All right, we got local Bulldog legend Ryan Marks in the house. We'll see if he's going to come and join us. Looks like he is.
Spreading it pretty thick there.
All right, so we got Ryan Marks on the radio with us. What do you got going on, Mr. Marks? Anything good?
Not a lot. I've been told I have a face for radio, so I thought I'd check it out.
Well, that matches because I got a voice for the newspaper, so...
Perfect.
All right. Another local legend, Brenton Ring, out in his Minnesota wrestling regalia. Benner down 7-0 here. Had some pretty good action on the JV side of the house. We've had a lot of falls, a lot of good movement on their feet. It was nice to see Cooper Mack get a win, especially when he had the opportunity to wrestle somebody that wasn't 20 pounds heavier than him. That's always nice.
Yeah, Coop looked good. Looked good and aggressive on his feet.
And we'll probably come back to this as we get into the varsity match, but if you heard any out of bounds, so Benner will take it back to the center of the mat, see if he can get something going from underneath. Other than Marty placing eighth at the Christmas tournament, had you heard any news out of the coaching staff on that prospect?
Well, Christmas tournament's pretty stiff order there. Obviously, our team's pretty young, not a whole lot of varsity experience. That was a pretty tough way to start the varsity season. A lot of people were coming in there with 10, 12 matches under their belt already, and all of our kids were coming in with zero. No fault of their own, fault of weather, fault of an extended football season. Pretty tough place to start your season out there. But it is what it is. Kids competed hard.
Yeah, I think Martin Prieto probably the shining star in that, with that eighth place finish at the Christmas tournament, which is pretty good. Coming in 0-0 with his first competitive matches of the season after playing 14 football games.
Yeah, and he I know he, I talked with him a little bit today. He was a little disappointed in his first match.
Sounds like you lost a couple of close ones.
Very close ones. Lost to a three-time South Dakota State champ, I heard out there. A very close match, and I want to say that kid, I know he was came all the way back into the third place match. I don't know if he ended up third or fourth, but Marty's got a world of potential. Again, unfortunate that was his first time out in the year, but you know, he showed a lot of grit coming back in those wrestle bag matches.
Well, that story in itself tells you an awful lot about that Christmas tournament for those out there that aren't really aware of what that program entails. You have a state champion out of South Dakota, and South Dakota is no slouches when it comes to high school wrestling.
No.
And that kid maybe came back and wrestled third.
Yeah. For people that know wrestling a little bit, there was a person ranked, I'm trying to think what weight class it was, 182 pounds, kid that wrestled Abe Assad at the Luther opening
and
beat him.
Right.
And that kid did not win the Christmas tournament. He's got a win over Abe Assad this year, but couldn't beat Bennett Berge at the Christmas tournament.
Abe Assad, wrestler for the University of Iowa, wrestling at the Luther Open, so he was able to beat a Division I wrestler at an open tournament down in Decorah, but did not win the Christmas tournament.
Could not win the Christmas
tournament in Rochester.
Yeah. And Abe Assad, not just a Division I wrestler, he's a Division I All-American.
Right.
He could beat him, but he couldn't win the Christmas tournament.
All right, we get a little action here. We get a nice high single leg.
Good finish. I like to hustle back to the middle here.
Who is that for us?
That looks like Hunter Johnson.
All right, so we got Hunter Johnson for the Bulldogs, and I did not hear what Paul Arsvold said on the public address system for Century here, but just by the pace of this match, it looks like we got a couple of kids here that have had a little mat time, maybe not this year, but at least in the past.
Right, right. No, Hunter wrestled JV for us last year, I know. He's going to have to kind of weather the storm here.
Yeah, Hunter, an eighth grader.
Get off on his offense a little bit.
Hunter does get an escape there.
He needs to get his own offense going here. So far, he's kind of let the match come to him a little bit.
39. I wonder if this is Dylan Jones, 130-pound ninth grader.
Good job of fighting off his back there.
But he would be about the closest weight-wise to Hunter on the sheet tonight.
Yeah, Hunter came in at 131 tonight. Right now he's got to get his
wrist back. Dylan came in at 131, too.
That wrist control for Century led to this armbar. Now it's a lot tougher to fight from here. Doing a good job of keeping his hips pasted on the mat here, and it looks like he's out of that bar.
Nothing going.
Switching to a half. Oh,
nothing going for the Century wrestler, so he lets it go. He's going to try something else.
Yeah. A lot of times a young wrestler doesn't realize how close that is to going. You know, they work at it, get kind of bored of it in a few seconds and try something else. Sometimes you just got to wear that muscle out a little bit.
8 seconds to play here in the first period. Mix my metaphors up a little bit. Green's choice.
Century built a pretty good 8-2 lead there that period. Going back to the feet.
Yeah, Hunter.
Century's had all the good leg attacks here. We got to get off on some legs of our own here.
Best defense I think Hunter could have here is to get his own offense going.
Yeah.
Down six is no place to take it easy. That's right. A nice double leg to Century Panther.
Got to get back here. Oh, he did get a couple near fall. I was going to say, if I was Century's coach, I'd be a little disappointed. No near fall on that situation, but looks like we got a couple. Oh, this is going to get tough here.
There's a pin for Century.
How many matches on the slate tonight? Did you get a copy?
I just informing one of our internet followers that we did not get a sheet on the JV matches tonight. Even ring announcer Paul Arsvold is getting them as the kids register at the table. So we have to kind of listen up for Paul here.
Gotcha.
Now, wrestling from Rochester Century, Dylan Jones,
and
from
Plainfield,
Nova, Heath Deming.
This is Jones.
This is Dylan Jones, ninth grader, and this is Heath Deming for the Bulldogs.
Yeah, Heath came on her leg here, a little stretched
right
out.
Dylan comes out sporting that old school Penn State Nittany Lions singlet, which, in my opinion, always had the belt a little low on it. I always thought it looked like a little saggy pants to me. But
I guess I was never in a spot to criticize.
Well, a lot of schools that are not the Nittany Lions have gone to that same singlet design.
That's
so
true. That's true.
All right, so Heath is down 2-0 here to a quick takedown. The Century Panthers JV has been aggressive on their feet early.
They have. Good strong half Nelsons, good double leg attacks.
Heath in a bit of a trouble here.
Yeah, long time to fight here.
45 seconds, a long time to wait though for,
yes,
there's the slap.
Yes, it is. Gravity's against you when you're there.
Yes.
Here, looks like you got Sam Ring coming out.
Something
here.
Something happened odd there that we didn't go back to the colors on the mat, but that was it's early in the year. You see some things like that from a tradition standpoint.
What do you think of the new singlets there, Mr. Brighton?
And Sam Ring.
Isaac Dieterman. I like those new singlets.
Yeah, I think they're pretty sharp as well. Nice snap down for Ring. Good head control. Got to get that hip back. Gonna get us two here. Working a good cross face here.
Thank you, Mr.
Yeah, teacher appreciation night tonight. We got Sam Ring out there, the junior for the Bulldogs. His favorite teacher tonight was German teacher Mike Heppner. Mike Heppner, native of Cologne, Germany. According to Sam, makes German fun.
I guess. Different strokes for different folks, maybe.
Good job, Mike Heppner.
Thank you.
All right, we go back to the center. Sam gets a takedown here. He's gonna try and Isaac gets a 1-point escape.
Sam's in nice low stance here.
Had the privilege of watching a couple of wrestle-offs up in the wrestling room in some really tight matches. Sam was involved in a couple of those and. It would not surprise me to see Sam wrestling in that second duel some this year, because he looked pretty tough up there.
That was a nice, solid attack. Didn't really risk a lot changing levels, just kind of got the momentum going his way and took that little snatch single.
Art critic in the internet audience wants to know if the mat is the correct Bulldog gold or the current Bulldog singlet is the correct Bulldog gold.
You know, I think maybe the camera is distorting it a little bit because they're pretty darn close in person.
They are very close.
I guess on the camera that mat looks a little orangier, but I'd say they both look darn good.
I mean, they don't look as good as Sam Ring has looked in this matchup, 4-1 with a couple of nice takedowns.
That's true.
And there's the buzzer. We'll go to the second period.
I guess if I was at the paint store looking for Bulldog Gold, I would buy Caterpillar Yellow. That's the closest I've found.
You don't just go to the website and get the CMK numbers and mix
no,
it?
No, that's definitely not the way to do it.
Heaven forbid you go chemistry on it.
No.
Nora's going to be mad at you.
I don't know why I would go to that much trouble when the fine people at Caterpillar already did the work for me.
You're saying a John Deere Yellow is not quite the Bulldog Gold?
No, it is not.
What about the John Deere Industrial Gold on their industrial equipment?
That is a little closer. I mean, Sam needs to get back to working that head again. He had a real nice couple.
Yep.
There he goes.
There's a nice
now back
snap
in a nice
again.
Snap again.
There
Using
we go. That length to his
there
advantage, he gets another takedown. It's going to go to 6-1.
Put that head down and things get easy. Doing a nice job of working that arm now. Good solid deep waist. Appears to have lots of gas left in the tank halfway through here.
Yeah, for early in the season, I know we've had a lot of pins, but our conditioning has looked pretty good on our JV kids so far.
Yeah.
And that's usually a pretty good reflection of the varsity.
This is really probably the longest JV match we've had so far, isn't it? We're almost to the third period. I guess Coop's match might have went to the third period.
I don't know if we had a blink on our...
Running a good barbed wire here. He's got to stretch that out. It's just about tipping. He's got to stick with it. If he could circle it back the other way, circle it back to Sam's left, stretch that thing out. It's going.
And he gets it rolled through. Dieterman successfully fights off of barbed wire, which doesn't happen very often.
No.
Maybe if we get Mike Matias in the house tonight, we can get him to tell his barbed wire story from college. That's a good one, folks. If you ever get a chance to hear that one, that's a gem.
It is. And of all Mike Matias's college stories, that's one that you could actually tell on the air.
Yeah, it is. That's pretty user-friendly.
Yeah.
Doesn't involve a tent, just a move that Mike did not think was coming.
No.
All right, so we'll go to third period. Sam's still up 6-1.
Back neutral again. Oh.
Technical violation on his shoelace.
Cheap point, but we'll take it.
Honestly, 6-1, 7-1, it's not going to make much difference to Dieterman. He's going to have to get on his pony and get scoring some points. That one point that leads to his worries at this point.
He's looking for one move at this point, regardless, I would guess. Sam needs to get back on that head and get back in that top position. Again, good movement for third period early in the season.
Ooh,
big snap.
Sam loses balance a little bit.
Good scramble out of it, though.
Good scramble.
Recovered quickly.
Sean Polson getting recognized by one of our junior high wrestlers as a favorite teacher for his organization and helpfulness. Sam with another takedown.
Another good snap.
Sam has been hard on the head tonight. I like to see that. That's a good skill. Even if it doesn't lead to that snap takedown, it'll lead to a lot of other stuff.
It leads to a really sore neck the next day
for the other
kid. And eventually when things get tired, you know, that might not always get you a first period takedown, but sometimes it's a takedown of attrition by the third period.
Right. That neck gets sore, it might help you turn a guy in the third period too.
A little bit of trouble here getting our leg caught a little high.
Yep, we're gonna get reversed by Dieterman.
That was probably the safe play right there. Versus hanging on to too long. Right?
Yep, give up the two rather than going to his back.
Sam needs to bring that right knee up to his ribs right here. If he brings that right knee up, he can pop up to his base. Now he's got to slide that left knee up and pop up. I think Sam's in a pretty good position here where he knows he's got a 6-point lead, and as long as he can fight off these half Nelsons, he's in a good spot to win the match.
Yeah, he's got got 20 seconds to ride here. He doesn't need to do anything. It's not like he needs one.
No.
He's going to get called for a stall. It's inconsequential.
It's not going to make any difference. It's a token call at this point.
Yeah, even if he gets one more, he just gives back the point on the shoelace.
Yeah.
So.
And there it is.
All right, so Sam Ring's going to be your winner, 9-3. His favorite teacher, Mike Hepner, pretty proud of him. Sam's going to get his hand raised for the, oh, we're still not raising hands, looks like.
Yeah, we're still not touching anybody yet.
We can shake hands, but we can't raise hands. That seems a little odd to me.
Well, I think they don't want the ref touching everybody's hands.
Cross contamination between weights. It's like we're going to have Logan Dietrich
action here. Logan's usually a pretty exciting wrestler. Comes with a lot of explosiveness on his feet.
Andrew Berkland. Oh, Ezra Berkland, I bet.
Mrs. Jones, are you in the house?
Oh, she's here. I saw her.
Logan Sybess. I was in the eighth grade. She's my favorite teacher because she treats everyone with care. Some things that stand out are just mostly treats, that she treats everyone fairly and is always in a good mood. Her best friend is watching the Rio. She made the classroom fun by not having much classwork and a project for herself, and the energy was great. If you take away from Mrs. Jones, you should always treat others with respect.
All right, Logan calls out Mrs. Jones from the elementary for his favorite teacher. Liked her a lot because he always taught her to treat people with respect. Logan, ninth grader on that Bulldog football team that went to the state finals, backup running back, but more than anything, played quite a bit of defensive line on that playoff run. All of that at a blistering 145.6 pounds.
He did. He had one of the best blocks of that semifinal game.
Yes, he did.
On that interception return.
On the pick, yep.
As a D-end, he got himself in position to make out. An absolute critical block on that return.
And
200-pound senior never saw it. I mean, he saw it coming, but he never saw it coming like that.
And not only was it a great block, but it also was instrumental in the return. It wasn't just fun to watch.
Nice little inside cradle there. Get the business going.
Logan gets the pin. Already reset the clock. I didn't see the time. Gonna pick up your wife?
I do, yeah. It's gonna be pretty short.
Was nice.
Short soiree into my radio career.
It was nice.
I thought I'd stop
it
in.
It was nice of us to maintain radio silence while you wrote me that note. What do we got here?
Some kind of a sideways headlock there.
Come on, Logan!
I think this is Logan Peterson for the second time tonight.
Mr. Lamb,
could
you please stand up?
All right. Head football coach Mr. Lamb going to be called out for a favorite teacher.
Mr. Lamb is currently my ninth grade English teacher. He's my favorite teacher because he explains things well and
thanks to Mr. Marks for dropping in at the broadcast table here. We'll see if we can get anybody else in here.
Something important I've learned from this class is that learning can be really fun. Thank you, Mr. Lamb.
I don't know if you're hearing this at home, but we're getting some nice comments out of the athletes, things they've written about their favorite teachers. Logan gets the pin. So let's see if what we're gonna do here looks like, I wonder if we're gonna be done. Not done for the night, folks, we're done with JV. All right, there we are. So the Bulldogs, if you're keeping score, it came out 36-27. I don't know what the match count was, things like that. Fun to see those young Bulldogs in action. That's the future of the program there. And I think it looks pretty bright there. Nice to see a couple of young ladies on the squad. I think that's also going to be a big swing in wrestling in the future. At the international level, women's wrestling is already very important. But just checking my notes here. At the international level, female wrestling at Olympic level, it is elite, is absolutely elite. It's moving into the college programs. It's an easy fit. You really don't add anything, but maybe a coach, maybe a bus. I don't know. It depends on what it is. It's an easy mix, whether it's Title IX or whatever. I think if you are out there and you got young girls that are interested in wrestling, you should let them give it a shot. There's going to be a lot of, you know, if you want to look at it this way, there's going to be a lot of scholarship money out there at these college programs that have to fill these rosters, especially early on in the system here. So, all right, Norb Marks is in the house. That being said, we're going to take a little bit of a break. We'll have the varsity out here. We'll get them warming up. We'll have the national anthem. And after that, the Bulldogs will go toe-to-toe with the Century Panthers. But until then, I'm going to go mute for just a little bit, and we will see you. right, Bulldogs take the gym for their first home dual meet of the season. 6:51. We got about 9 minutes to showtime, and Bulldogs will warm up a little bit here. We'll listen to some warm up music. We'll scan. No.
And
all right, welcome back, everybody. We'll get tonight's announcements. All right, so we're joined here with Sam Ring's favorite teacher. He makes it both fun and interesting, but he is also here. Let's turn it over to ring announcer Paul Arswald for the starting lineups, then we'll chat.
At 120 pounds, receiving the forfeit from Plainville to Millville, Nolan Ford. Wrestling at 126 pounds from Rochester Century, Nate Ellingson. And from Plainville to Millville, Nolan Fonsticker. There will be a double forfeit at 132 pounds. At 138 pounds, wrestling for the Panthers, Isaac DeWandi. And for the Bulldogs, Darian Waldron. At 145 pounds, receiving a forfeit for the Bulldogs, Kyler Lamb. Wrestling at 152 pounds from Rochester Century, Sam Johnson. And from Plainville to Millville, Dominic Michael. At 160 pounds, for the Panthers, Sam Jack. And for the Bulldogs, Alex Henricks. At 170 pounds, receiving a forfeit for the Bulldogs, Alex Gustad. At 182 pounds, wrestling from Rochester Century, Nevin DeGaffarelli. And from the Bulldogs, Devin Hutchinson. Wrestling at 195 pounds, for Rochester Century, Nate Miller. And from Plainville to Millville, Martin Branco. At 220 pounds, from Rochester Century, Jack Beekler. And from Plainville to Millville, Drew Raymond. And at 285 pounds, wrestling for the Panthers, Zeke Hines. And for the Bulldogs, Tony Robertson. Rochester Century is coached by Joel Messick, Brian Russell, Steve Larson, Nathan Jones, and Jerry Larson. The Bulldogs are coached by Steve Henry, Steve Palsticker, Bobby Benson, Derek Winger, Cam Miller, Garrett Miller, Cole Williams, and Jeff Cargill. Is this Jordan Schumacher handy?
All right, so Tackle Cancer Night tonight. Steve Henricks got a little gift for Jordan Schumacher, PEM alum, currently battling cancer. And that was her sister, Ashlyn, sang the national anthem.
Jordan Schumacher was diagnosed with Hodgkin's lymphoma. Jordan has shown her grit by battling this disease through chemo, but also with a no-quit attitude. Jordan's demeanor is that this is just a bump in the road of life and to seize the challenge that lies before her. The PEM community has responded by wearing purple wristbands and t-shirts to help support her cause. Tonight, purple wristbands can be purchased from Julia Mailing. Julia, stand up. And t-shirts through her mom, Amy Schumacher. Amy? Tonight, we welcome Jordan onto the mat and are proud that she's showing the PEM wrestling model grit. Jordan has shown the gutsy attitude to fight Hodgkin's lymphoma, the resiliency to pick herself up after setbacks. She continues to improve after two chemo treatments and knows the PEM team is behind her. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Jordan Schumacher.
Yeah. Suppose Mr. Hendricks gave Jordan a basket of fruit from the FFA.
Well, it is very nutritious.
It is.
And they have plenty of extra.
All right. So, welcome to the Bulldog Gymnasium tonight. I'm joined on my right by Mike Hepner, joined on my left by Mr. Ryan Marks. I brought Mr. Hepner up here real quick. And Mr. Arswald's talking, so we'll let him chat it out here.
Let's wrestle.
Starting us off tonight at 106 pounds, from Rochester Century, Mason Teal, and from Plainfield, Florida, Aaron Greener.
All right. So we got Aiden Greener for the Bulldogs. Mason Teal for the Century Panthers.
Aiden's controlling the mat right now. He's taking a lot of space here.
Bulldogs have been heavy on that head all night tonight. We saw that in the JV match.
Ooh, right into an inside cradle here. This is
Aiden
trouble.
Working that too.
This is trouble for Teal.
Yeah. Aiden's got it tight.
Big trouble here. Nice job, Aiden.
Aiden gets a pin for his favorite teacher, Mrs. Lori Yankowski, elementary teacher that made a big impact on his life. So we're going to see Carson Raymond and Gabriel Collies roll out here at 113. Bulldogs get a quick pin at 106 out of Aiden Greener.
That might have been Aiden's first win in this gym. I know he had a big varsity win at the Christmas tournament over Vaughn from Cassin Manorville.
But his first home Bulldog win.
First home Bulldog win in a varsity single, anyway.
All right. So here at 13, we got Carson Raymond, younger brother of Alex Raymond, graduated last year, had a good season for the Bulldogs last year. Carson in on a quick take now. He's got that arm, that trying to bar that arm up. He's got a 2-on-1 there.
Doing a nice job controlling that wrist, keeping pressure forward. He's going to stay out on his toes.
He's going to try and back hook that arm and get a tilt here if he can. It's going to be a little early for that. He's got to wear his man down a little bit. Hey, Mr. Hepner, what do you know about the Knowledge Bowl?
Just really quickly, Knowledge Bowl is a great event, but this is tonight about wrestling. Knowledge Bowl is just kind of like Jeopardy for the younger grades and for the older grades. It's a great activity besides sports. But tonight is really about the team here. I think it's great for our team to recognize Jordan Schumacher and also all the teachers that have made a difference in the life of these wrestlers. So I want to thank Coach Steve Hendricks on making this happen. And it should be a great night for the town of Plainville, Jamilville, as well as the wrestlers.
All right. Thanks, Mr. Hepner. All right. Carson trying to work that outside cradle. He's going to cut his man here.
Yeah, he's going to go up 2-1. There. We lost some everything here.
Oh, I know how to fix that.
All those at home, I know you can hear us, you can't see us. We had somebody trip over a wire, I think. Right now, Carson Raymond got his second takedown. He's got a 4-1 lead. Now he should be back here. Working a good bar. Couple near fall out of it.
All right, looks like we're back video-wise. 6-1 going into the second for Carson Raymond. All right, Carson's going to take the top position. I didn't see if he deferred or what happened there, but Panther wrestler Callies is going to see if he can get out from underneath, get another 1 point, get back to his feet. Quick sit out.
Right back to that wrist.
Yep. Raymond ties up an arm. You don't get much on a sit out scooting on your hip, but you can get back to your base, which he's got to do. So
I would guess the PEM staff will give him a minute. Yeah, maybe not even that long to see if we can get a turn here, but then get back on the feet.
Yep.
Raymond's looked really good on his feet. Definitely want to open up the gap a little bit on this kid. Looking for some bonus points here, maybe.
say, referee taking a close look there is going to tell Alex, or Alex, going to tell Carson to work up.
Working that head again like we did in the other ones. Good spin.
All right.
Wouldn't shock me if Coach Filesticker has him get another takedown here.
Yep, you hear Coach Winger telling him to cut him, and here we go. We're back on our feet, 8-3.
Sometimes when you wear those kids out a little bit, they're easier to turn after, you know, three, four, five takedowns. And sometimes you can get a takedown right to their back.
Yep, just like that. That's tight. And there's a slap at 3 minutes and 12 seconds. So Bulldogs out to a quick lead here, 12-0.
Good way to start.
Nolan Ford will come out here for a to take a forfeit at 120. And then we should see Nolan Filesticker and Nate Ellingson at 126 pounds.
Winner by a forfeit, Nolan Ford.
Nolan almost tripped there. I don't know if you saw that. The paw almost
got
him. Hey, Cyrus, how you doing, buddy? Cyrus gives me the thumbs up.
Now, wrestling at 126 pounds for the Panthers, Nate Ellingson. For the Bulldogs, Nolan Filesticker.
All right. Did Nolan wrestle the varsity at the Christmas tournament?
He did. Okay. He did. And he did have a varsity match or two last year as well.
Oh, okay.
So Ellingson comes out pretty full of fire here, working that leg tilt.
Nolan, just a ninth grader, kind of looking to find his feet. Switched from football to cross country this year, had a good season in cross country. Out for wrestling now, and just kind of working his way through here.
Gotta fight this half right here. Yeah. Had a little full Nelson action there. Must not have been enough for the ref to stop it.
Must have been a 7-8 Nelson.
Yeah, it could have been a 7-8. Nolan's kind of got to weather this storm of physicality right here.
Yeah,
he's got very good conditioning.
Yeah, if we can
weather this storm and start building away at something of his own here.
Say if he can get out of this 2-0, 2-1 without giving up anything silly.
So far that half hasn't been too successful.
Ellingson working hard, but Filesticker fighting it off. He's up to his feet. He gets to break the hands. He's got 1 point. See if Nolan get a little bit of his own offense going here.
Ideally, he's got to slow Ellingson down a little bit.
Right.
There we go.
He's behind us. If we can return.
Oh, that's where we got to have a mat return.
Got to finish there, Filesticker.
This means I'm super good.
All right. Cyrus checks in. Super good. All right. Filesticker missed an opportunity at a varsity takedown there early in the match here.
Nice go behind. Nice shot.
And now he's in deep again. He's going to run out of time, I think. Don't give up two here. There you go. No takedown.
Must have had just enough leg there. Leg.
Taught puppets to teach. I learned many things from Mrs. Montgomery, but the most memorable thing, she taught me how to spell.
Other cancer survivor. Night. All right.
Well, spelling is important.
Smelling is important, as all the COVID sufferers have learned. Smelling.
Spelling.
Oh, spelling with a P.
With a P. We lost it again here.
No, I think we're good. We just got to go.
Oh, I guess we're all right.
All right.
My dad fell asleep.
So we go to
second period.
I did not.
Oh, nice high C. We got to get this fought off here.
Nolan's got to use that length to his advantage.
We're in a good position here if we can stuff that head.
Nolan fights it off successfully.
You know, that's a situation where as a young wrestler you feel pretty good to get out of there without giving up a takedown. But as he goes back and watches that on film, he'll realize he should have had two there.
Should have had his own two.
That's a real good scoring opportunity. Yep. He had that stopped. He had the guy stretched out. This is a nice shot.
Third nice shot. Third nice offensive action.
Good job
for File
Sticker. Got to pop that up. Oh, we got a little. Good scramble.
A little scramble there. Nolan comes out on the short end. So File Sticker is going to be down 4-1 here. Two takedowns. We'll see if Nolan can get an escape. File Sticker can get an escape. Ellingheisen got a big motor on him. He's really been really go this whole time. Seems to be slowing down a little bit in the second period here.
We got to stop this here.
Might have got away with a little. It might have got away with a little headgear grab on that half Nelson. Nolan trying to drive that back shoulder through.
Quite a lot of
pretty
time
tight
here through. We're sinking in a pretty tight headlock here at this point. He's fighting hard. 30 seconds to fly here.
Right. No. Oh, and there's the slap at 3:37. File Sticker fights off a couple of hard attacks. Not hard attacks, hard attacks.
Yeah. Nolan had his chances
there. Yeah, Nolan's going to be okay. A lot of people worried about Nolan. Well, maybe not a lot, but I know Mr. Marks and I are not. He'll be fine. He's going to be good to go.
At 132, we have a double forfeit.
I think we maybe had some sickness involved.
I think we did have some illness-related forfeits there. I know both teams have bodies there normally.
Right.
Would have saw senior Jacob Harlow there normally.
Yep.
All right, well, Gary and Waldron. Gary had a real strong day on Saturday. Came back with a couple wins in that second chance bracket on Saturday.
Nice.
In fact, I think he had 3 wins.
Isaac Dewangdi, one of 2 Dewangdis on the Century roster. I would assume they're brothers, but not a real common name, so they are related at the least.
Yeah, you would think so. That would be quite a coincidence.
It's not like it's John Smith.
No. Gary trying to work that Russian tide. It was sweep there.
I think sometimes those young guys, they like that Russian tie, but they forget the circle with it. And they get enchanted with getting locked up in that tie and getting in the right position, and they forget to run their feet.
Garen had a nice motor on that single leg himself. Just kept staying on it. Yeah, that Russian tie, you got to get your hips into it a little bit. If you want to score off it. Sometimes when you're just hanging on it, it's a good tie to not let the other guy do anything. But if you want to score from it, you got to get your hips in on it.
Yeah, I think sometimes the teaching of the Russian tie.
Right to his back. Got to come up with that half right there.
The teaching of the Russian tie sometimes involves so much technique that what gets lost is the power that's required to control it.
Correct. Kids that wrestle a little Greco-Roman in the offseason, they develop a good Russian tie.
Right.
At the very least, they learn how to stay out of it, if nothing else.
Absolutely. Waldron with a good return to the mat.
Oh, good bar here. He's got a good-looking bar on. Got to get his hips behind it. Get him stretched out. 10 seconds. Might be going to run out of time here. This will be in his back pocket for later, though. That'll go later.
Yeah, Wilson, we're going to see that wing again.
Yep.
I was trying to get Osage native Ben Peter up here to chat with us so I could be on the winning side of this argument. But growing up in Iowa, we would call that a wing. And when the arm goes all the way behind the back, that's what we would call a bar. So if you hear me call that a wing out there in Bulldog land, I mean, you can yell at your YouTube if you want to, but don't get nervous.
That's okay. Yeah.
See, that's why I needed Coach Peter up here. I needed another vote.
We always referred to a wing as when that bar got illegal. When that bar slid up the back, that's when it became a wing. Oh, terminology. When that arm was on the back, we'd always call that a hammer lock, not a bar.
Yep, a hammer, yep.
Some of the old timers would call it a dugstead or a country boy as well.
Yep.
have heard all of those.
We're right back in this bar, though. I'm going to call it a bar again because we're in Plainview. He's got to stretch that weight forward. He's got to keep his hips behind that, keep that tight, bump those hips forward. Crazy thing, if this was a college match, bottom guy would have been called for stalling twice already by now.
Yep. Gearing doing a good job working that arm.
He's stacked it back the other way.
Here it comes. Almost.
He's got him flattened out, if nothing else, out of that stack. He's got to get his right foot out to the side. There he takes that big step. It's going to go here.
Yep.
He's got to stick on it and not get bored with this. It's going to go once that shoulder gets tired. We got plenty of time. Still got a minute on this here. Got to get that forward pressure. He kind of let that kid get his hips back under him again. Gotta chop it back down.
Trying to load him up for that tilt again. He's going to use that bar however he can. He doesn't care if it comes at him or away from him. He's going to use it.
Gary's chest is getting a little out in front of that bar right now. You got to keep it behind it. Got to use that knuckles to drive forward. Here it goes. Here it goes. Really got to get some near fall out of this. This is still a one-point match.
There he's got him. Oh, he's going to roll through. Lost the far wrist. He's going to give up one, not two. One, not two. Give up one, not two here, Gary.
Get out of his front head here and watch our ankles. Got to stay actively circling. Keep that ankle back. Gary looking to maybe hit a little Kelly of his own here.
Yeah,
I think we're
going to
end up 3-3 at this period.
There we go. I'll take that, 3-3, based upon what could have happened on that bar gone awry.
Yeah, yeah. I'd like to get some points out of that bar, but.
I feel like Gary and I'll get one more chance at least at that.
We are where we are.
I was going to say, too, for the young guys watching at home, one thing Gary has to be careful of, too, is that hand that he's got across his opponent's back on that bar. He's got to keep it straight across. He did a good job camouflaging that with his chest, but it was riding up a little high there for a little bit.
That's what we'd have called a wing. Gary's got to get this left elbow clear here. He's kind of giving that arm.
Trying to tripod up to his feet, reaching back for a little Ben Swanson.
Yeah, good way to take a ride if you come up without that hand control. Haven't seen many people be able to pull that off like Ben. Essentially got away with a little bit of a clasp there.
Luongi,
you got to get on this cross face.
Luongi hanging in tight.
There we go.
The gym is really loud tonight. It's fun to be at the dual meets full of people again.
It is. Sure is.
Last year,
we
got to
pop our head out and we got a takedown here if we get this head out.
There it is. Go. Good job for Garion. Goes to 6-3.
That was big to get that one and then the two. He didn't come back to his feet and relax at all. Went right after that single leg.
Yep.
Garion also is a kid with a big time motor.
Yeah, Bulldog's up 12 here.
Great conditioning. He's getting a little high on this. Getting a little high. We can give up a reversal here, but we can't give up these near fall points.
20 seconds.
That's fairly tight as well.
Time is not our friend.
It's going to be a shame if Garion can't pop out the other side of this. He's dominated this entire match. Got a little high on his ride, gave up the head.
Be lucky to get out of this.
He survives it. Going to end up losing 8-6 in a match that he led all the way through. That's a heartbreaker for Garion.
Absolutely.
I mean, it might be a little shot of gorilla juice for the Panthers. We'll see.
That's one he'd like to have back for sure.
Century High School principal Nate Walbrook enthused by the win over there.
Now 145 pounds.
Yeah.
All right, Kyler Lamb out for wrestling this year. He's going to take a forfeit. You know, another member of that state finalist football team.
Now wrestling at 152 pounds for the Panthers, Sam Johnson, and the Bulldogs, Dominic Mike. Michael.
All right, so we got Sam Johnson for the Panthers. We got Dominic Michael for the Bulldogs. And Dominic goes right to that front head off a Johnson shot. He's going to give up two here.
Nope,
well, maybe
he's not either.
Nope,
he's going to come right into it.
There we go.
There we go. Dominic, very physical at 152 pounds. He looks good at that 152 weight class.
He does.
This is getting tighter by the second. Wear this kid out. This kid's still got a lot of energy underneath.
Yep.
But he's staying in good position. Lots of time. Still a minute 20 on the clock. This is where we don't want to be, though. We don't want to get this roller coaster.
Right. Looks like the Festivus tournament a little bit out there right now.
The Grinch and Santa Claus. There we go. Now let's settle this down. We're back to square one here at 5-5.
Yeah, we're going to be 5-5 after a minute. Couple of near misses by both wrestlers on their backs. Michael comes out firing first and pretty dominating, and a takedown straight to the back. Sam Johnston able to fight off his back and reverse Michael to his back, so we're back to zero, essentially a brand new match, 1 minute in.
Gonna pop this up. Not a real great position to be in right here for either guy.
Right. Dominic, physicality making up for his technicality a little bit here.
Things have slowed down a little bit, not quite so.
Saw some interesting things on that attempt at Peterson. We turned toward the head. We had a lot going on there.
Working that good ankle right here. Good crossface.
Yep. Nice.
Working
physical.
In a little butcher. Couple key points there at the end of that period.
Dominic Michael almost able to muscle himself to another Turk for two more points, but he ran out of time and a clock.
He did actually get two more.
Oh, did he get
Got
two there?
More. Yeah,
all right,
nine,
there we go.
Now.
So go 9-5. We'll go to the second period. It looks like we maybe got a little blood time.
A little
time.
Bit of blood time.
Mr. Coyle, will you sit it up again?
Well, Mr. Coyle getting to stand up a bunch of times tonight.
The Fillmore Central Falcons making an appearance tonight.
They are.
Well,
it is Nestivus Day today. So we do need some Falcons. I don't know if there are many schools that can brag about an English department that has two staff members that have won ribbons for showing hugs.
Nice. That is a true story.
That's got to be kind of a PEM
Betzler and
claim
Coyle.
To fame there, don't you think? I mean, yeah. Dominic looking like he's got to work a little kink out of his shoulder here.
Yep.
Quick breakdown here. It'd be nice to see him hook that ankle and go back to work on that crossface.
Yep.
We got to bar him, though.
Got to bar that up.
Got to straighten that out. Slow it down here. Slow things down.
One thing that Dominic has not done. It settled those moves, and it cost him.
There we go.
Much.
This is big.
There you go. Dominic with the pin.
Good job of settling.
2 minutes and 17 seconds. A lot of action.
After that win.
Yeah, a lot of action in that match.
It was 13 points there in a minute and change.
Yep. And when we say near falls, not just the points, actual near falls.
Close to a fall.
My big takeaway I have from the class is always to stay positive and keep working hard. Find what you love and work hard at it. Thank you, Mrs. Montgomery.
Mrs. Montgomery getting a shout out second time tonight.
All right, looks like we got Alex Henricks coming up for the Bulldogs.
We're gonna have Sam Jack. Sam Jack for the Panthers against Alex Henricks for the Bulldogs. Alex Henricks, I think, since his initial varsity matches early in his career, I believe has grown about 18 inches.
Yeah, that's probably fair. That's probably fair, both in height and wingspan. That was a nice low single attempt there. Yeah, he's a long-looking 60-pounder for a ninth grader. He's going to be a good-looking wrestler.
Another kid off of that state football tournament team. A lot of power in those kids out of the power program that Coach Lamb and Coach Wingert and company put together in there. So we'll see a lot of explosion out of those kids. Alex has got that bar again.
Yeah, Alex played a big role on special teams in that tournament run.
There's a bar and a half. That's going to be
tough to get out of. We got a long time yet. This kid is wishing he was somewhere else.
Let's see what you got. 9.5 feet of arms on Henrik wrapping you up. A little bit like wrestling a spider.
That's a nice win for Alex.
That is a nice win. Nice pin.
And it's getting to that point. One more win will ice it for the Bulldogs here. I always thought, if there's 84 possible points in a dual meet, when you get to 42, you can't be beat anymore.
One more.
Yeah. That'll do it.
And there you go. Bedstead with the forfeit is going to ice the dual meet. So now we go to 182 pounds. Everything.
We got the Bulldog youth wrestlers over there doing their best bleacher rendition of We Will Rock You.
Nevin Gafferty for the Panthers and Devin Hutchison for the Bulldogs. Yet another Bulldog football player.
Another Bulldog footballer. Devin's getting himself down to 182 this year. Did quite a bit for us last year at 95. Devin's been a little under the weather this week.
Trying his best
here.
We'll see how his conditioning is. I would guess it's not going to be great based upon the coffee.
Yep. Mr. Brighton getting honored right now with the stand-up. Hutchie's trying to work out. Oh, little short roll. Lost the wrist. Got to recover. Quick attempt at a half. Hutchie got to get his head off the mat and work his knees up. Getting that head off the mat will make that half a little tougher to get through as well. All right, Mr. Brighton receiving some applause. Oh, we got to get out of this half here. When you hang that head low, ooh, there was I'd call that a 15-16th Nelson right there. Could have been metric. Might have been an 18 mil Nelson.
Yes.
It was pretty dang close, though.
Devin, again, a little bit like Nolan earlier in that facing a real active, real physical Panther wrestler right off the top and kind of weathering the storm. He's going to come out of this 2-0 going to the second period.
Not bad. Still within striking distance if he can get something going here.
Mr. Peter.
That is the second time today, Mr. Brighton. I've heard somebody proclaim how fun glow in the dark dodgeball was.
I think they just like throwing balls at other kids in the dark.
Maybe. I might have to take that under advisement. I have a set on glow-in-the-dark dodgeballs I've never taken out of the package.
I would venture to guess this gym get plenty dark, too, if you wanted it to.
Yeah, it probably would. It probably would.
All right, we're going to go out of bounds. Devin gives up a reversal. Was it a reversal?
No,
takedown.
That was a takedown. That was a takedown.
Because they went both on their feet. I was busy listening to Mr. Peter get recognized by Alex Bedstead as an influential adult teacher in his life. Not an adult teacher, an adult or teacher.
Not a teacher of adults.
No.
Hutchie had good first movement there, but then Century kind of weathered the storm, got that broken back down. Biggest thing, we got to get this head off the mat. it's tough to get away with the head on the mat, and it's easy to get half Nelson.
Yep. Or 16 millimeter.
Yes. We're pretty close again here.
As we get into this.
Now we're doing a better job of keeping the head up.
Get into the later half of this second period and into the third period, we'll see how Devin's recent health will affect his conditioning.
Yeah, I know he's fighting hard right now under there. Giving himself a chance. He's still within striking distance if he can get out of this and get in a position where he can score.
I don't always agree with that stalling call on the bottom when a guy's trying to run that half. And he's hip to hip. I don't know what the ref really thinks he should be doing, because you don't want to come up with that half in there, and you don't want to.
Top man's doing a nice job of hopping side to side, though, staying active. And you know, if you're the bottom man and your head is down, it's pretty easy for the ref to call that call.
I understand where it comes from, but I sometimes wonder what the ref would like you to do.
Sometimes it's just a reward to the top man
for working.
Yeah,
exactly. So we get to the end of the second period. Another 2-point period for the Panthers. We're going to go 4-0 to the third.
Panthers going top. Panthers going top. Devin needs to put 2 good minutes together here. Start with a good hard first move coming out. We went to that short sit series a couple times here and it hasn't quite worked out. I'd like to see him hit a good stand up here. Back to that long sit.
Devin,
this is
Devin having a little trouble getting past that knee and elbow base where he can actually get any movement on the bottom. And I don't know if DeGafferly is giving us that good of top pressure, if we're running out of gas, or maybe a little bit of both.
DeGafferly's doing a nice job of staying behind the arms, working his sides. He's not really getting himself out of position, but he's hopping sides really well. Making himself real active. This half is a little better buried.
And then he switches out of it.
Switches out of it, man.
He was all the way in and up over the top of the skull, and yeah, that was right where he wanted to be. That might have
dodged the bullet on that one.
Yeah.
Hutchie's still working hard down here. Physically exhausted.
All right, we're going to get dinged on the bottom again.
Again, 1 point there for a second stall warning.
Gafferly picks up another one, pushes it to 5-0.
Gafferly pretty content to win this by a decision, it looks like. He's still slipping from side to side on that half. That wing roll, we got to suck that wrist in much tighter if that's going to go.
That's the second very scary wing roll that Devin has attempted. We maybe need to
when you reach check, that arm all the way that, back over the
check
top.
Check that on film and see if we can't fix that a little bit.
If he can sink into that right wrist right now.
Don't get cradled up here. Got short time, 10 seconds.
We're in that cradle. Oh, this could be bonus points.
Ooh, and we're going to get a pin with 4 seconds left. That's a 5:56 pin. Push it to 48-21. So we're going to see probably our best, our best returning starter for the Bulldogs in Martin Prieto. And he's going to be going up against Nate Miller for the Panthers.
Got the Gasolina intro again. Nice high C right off the bat.
Martin Prieto recently announcing he's going to be going to RCTC next year, and he's not only going to go to school, but he's going to wrestle for the Yellow Jackets.
Going to join the Storm over there with Coach Hack.
Yep. Another nice high C. Let's call that a Bazigar.
I wouldn't call that a Bazigar finish, no. Marty, if you would call this a flaw, sometimes he's overly active. He sometimes... he's in deep and he wants to hit something else. Like right here, he's got to just finish his single. He's in on a great shot right here. Now he's going to hit that Bazigar.
Okay.
There we go, Bazigar. difference really is in the, and again, it's terminology, but we would always call that when you're on a head on the inside single and you come across and elevate that leg, we'd call that a bar cigar. Okay. If you're from Nebraska, you call that a bar cigar.
Then off that high crotch, just call that cut into a double.
Yeah, I just call that doubling across.
Just think, we have one more home event, we'll have this all dialed in.
Yes, we will. When in Rome, you got to use Wabasha County technology or terminology, I think.
We did get a little. All right. Mr. Mark's getting identified as a person of influence in Martin Prieto's life. And his old man strength. All right, nice moving tribute to Ryan Marks from Marty Prieto. Marty putting on a takedown for cancer clinic.
He is.
He's been in deep a couple times. Edge of the mat, he's going to get another one here.
Oh, that's a heartbreaker to give that one up right at the end of the period.
That's like scoring at halftime and then kicking off to him. Marty goes
that's
down.
Right.
I think Marty's going to be okay here. It's 4-2. He's definitely. Marty's done. I think Marty scored every point in this match so far. He's two takedowns and he's given him two escapes.
Yep. So. Good initial movement off the bottom. We're not going to waste much time down
here. Control of hand here and he's out for his one.
Right away, we're going to see some good movement and level changes out of Martin. Good job of pulling the head, moving the feet.
In deep.
Marty's going to like that 50-foot college mat,
yes,
I think.
Yes, he is.
That's going to be his
I was
friend.
Just going to say, what Marty needs a bigger mat.
Yeah, these 28 feet run out pretty fast for him. When he gets those feet rolling, it's tough to stop that momentum.
Might have to spend a little time in practice running in a circle. Circle that single leg in that high crotch back toward the middle instead of straight across, maybe. If he's going to be that fast running that through there.
That was a nice attempt there by Century.
Yeah, this,
no slouch. That was a good, solid penetration step.
Nate Miller here is proving to be a worthy opponent.
Absolutely.
What we don't have here is any sort of records or any.
Oh, this is going to be nice. I think that might have been a little premature, but it's definitely two now.
Yeah, now it's two. I think he gave it up a little early,
yeah.
But fortunately for the ref, it worked out to where we didn't argue it.
Not that I would have argued it anyway.
But no, but anybody. Panthers might have argued it if he'd have been able to score a lot of
there. This is a good move
there.
Here, I think, going back to the feet.
I think so, too. Don't waste a lot of energy holding them down.
You know,
don't have to worry about a roll or any sort of weird reversal.
Best case scenario, you ride him out to the end. Martin, you know, Miller's a solid wrestler. He's not going to go over and a half Nelson or get cradled up. This way, Martin's got a chance to widen the gap out a little bit. Worst case scenario, when you try and ride him out the period, you give up one with you know, 10, 15 seconds left. You don't have time to get more points.
Right.
Now we at least got 20 seconds. I wouldn't be surprised if Martin's in on another shot here before we're done.
I say Martina, an excellent wrestler in all the phases, but definitely excels on his feet.
Absolutely.
And that is going to
be out of room again. Another nice shot.
Another takedown that we're not going to get credit for.
Martin does such a great job of getting the motion, slowing down the motion, and then changing speeds on it like that. Excellent speed change.
Marty is like the smart kid taking a quiz and everybody around him is getting A's that he's not getting credit for.
Right. That is a good analogy. Or is that a metaphor? I teach Phi Ed.
it's a comparison of sorts.
All right.
All right, we're getting ready.
Wouldn't shock me if they, I was going to say, I bet they put him back on his feet again.
Yeah, we're going to the third period here.
In a season where we're already short on matches, we need Martin to get all the practice he can in these matches.
Yeah.
This real competition action here. And this Miller's proven to be a good opponent on his feet. This is good. These are the type of takedowns Martin's going to need to get at the end of the season. That was a good reshot. Good reshot by Miller. Martin getting the hips down. Miller's lost his position on this. Best case on this, Miller's going to stalemate this out. Martin's got to break that grip. Miller's not super stretched out in his arms, though. He'll be able to hang out of here for a while.
Right.
Referee could do us all a favor and stalemate this here quickly.
Call it out of bounds.
I don't think we're going to go anywhere.
Call it out of bounds and get us back to the middle with some time on a clock. Haven't had a lot of time to shout out to the Bulldog Nation Foundation bringing this live stream to you. Right. It's been just a packed gym tonight. Good crowd. Nice to have everybody back at a live event. Marty's going to get another takedown here.
Nice. And that's where you get bonus points. We just about had that kid packed on his back there.
Yep.
We're going to have a tough time getting bonus from here.
I'll
get back on the feet again.
Those good, hard double legs like that, those are demoralizing for Miller when he's been hanging.
It is.
And now things are not going his way. We're going to go at one. We're going to go back to our feet. We'll see if Prieto can score another takedown here.
Martin might still be in a little bit of football shape here. Which is not meant to be an insult to football shape.
Especially considering that he never came off the field, which
is
football shape a little bit different than some kids. He's in deep again.
That was beautiful. Now we're getting some bonus points. Got to work up to that head.
Miller not only getting tired, but getting a little demoralized there. He's not quite popping back to his hip on that takedown like he was.
Now we can ride this out.
Marty up 10 here.
Marty's going to want one more takedown here. And again, these takedowns, inconsequential in this dual meet right now, but these are the type of things that make you improve for later in the year.
Right.
You know, you might have 14 seconds left in a match, and you absolutely need a takedown in late February.
This is the takedown Marty's working on for the section tournament. See if he can squeak it out here with 2-1. He's not going to. It's going to be a 9-point win for Prieto.
Good takedown clinic by Marty. Good effort there by Miller. He's a solid opponent.
Hey, Dan Miller, can you hear me now? That was at 7:06. I don't know what happened. He said we can see us, but he can't hear us.
No, wrong. You read that dyslexic. They could hear us, but they couldn't see us.
That was when we fixed the camera.
Went. Yeah.
Thanks.
Better late than never.
Better Nate than Lever.
It's like we're going to have Drew Raymond here against young Danny Draxler.
Danny Draxler, a blast from the past out of the football archives of PEM.
Jeff Ziegler.
Beekler. Like Nestavis Beekler.
Well, that's pretty close to Draxler.
Yeah, I'd give you that. Even give me a little Dorn, maybe a little...
Yeah. All right, Drew's working this underhook. Like a lot of upper weights go, a little bit of feeling each other out here to start.
Yeah, Drew Raymond, just a ninth grader, correct?
Correct.
Just a ninth grader at
220. Good looking ninth grader.
Good. Had some varsity experience last year at 220, I think. If I remember correctly.
Much like Jerry Seinfeld, you wouldn't know what to look at Drew, but he's actually really fast.
Yes. Whether he gets a head start or not.
Yeah. Yep.
I will say this. We were talking, that was a nice low single attempt out of Beekler. I noticed on these Panther singlets, apparently I'm the fashion police tonight with my Christmas shirt on, but looks on the back, they have some sort of like sublimated image on there. It almost looks like it's
I thought that
wet.
Was just sweat. Yeah.
It looks wet, but it's a...
I thought that kid just had a good warm-up in.
Some sort of... Yeah. Heavy on the head, both these 220s. Kind of heavyweight waltzing here
right,
through the first
right.
period.
This match may come down to a takedown, may come down to who's better on the mat.
Right, who can get their one from underneath.
Yep. Good period, though. Both guys stayed in good position. A lot of people ask me sometimes why those upper weights, you know, not as aggressive as the lower weights. It's a lot bigger risk to penetrate
yes.
at an upper weight.
Yes.
You know, high reward, but also way high risk.
All-American from Iowa, Tony Cassiope, just got pinned, I think, by a kid from Princeton.
Yeah.
On a
yeah,
high-risk, high-reward kind of deal where he took a shot and got on his back and got a big get on a big kid, and it's tough to
yep.
get out of there.
You got 400 pounds bearing down on those shoulder blades. That's a nice first
nice
move by
Drew. Movement out of Jerry Seinfeld or Drew yeah. Raymond, faster than he looks. Agile for
yep,
a big
that
guy.
That was agile. That was a nice nice inside switch there. Got Beekler leaning a little bit.
So it's Drew Raymond calf-like reflexes.
Nah, he looked good there. Doing a nice job keeping that ankle hook, working a good hard crossface. Looks like he wants to get into a little butcher action here. I would guess Coach Miller's been working with him on that. He's got to get his ankle unhooked. I think that butcher might be there. Trying, some people out there right might remember Logan Wingert's butcher that he would
yes.
always use. That was thanks to Coach Miller as well.
Logan Wingert probably got about 100 career pins on that butcher in his life.
I want to say he was at 90 career
pins,
and most of them came from that butcher.
Probably 75
yeah.
of them came on that butcher.
Yeah, that's, and considering that kid never wrestled any weight but heavyweight.
Yep.
And probably never in ninth grade. This butcher's going to go. He's got to load it up just a little more. It could go. He's going to run out of real estate if he circles too hard around the front. He's got to load it up towards us. If he could jerk that thing towards us, a couple little taps. 30 seconds yet.
This is one of those things with a young wrestler where the coaches are yelling at him, and he just doesn't have quite the mat savvy yet to give a jerk on that forearm.
Yeah,
that
he lost that
arm.
Good grip now. Nevertheless, he's worn this kid out.
Oh, absolutely.
Beekler's used a lot of energy trying to come up.
Don't give up one now. You got four seconds to go.
Keep that kid down.
Don't give up your cheap one. There you go.
Keep that
rest.
Interesting to see what the coaching staff has Beekler do here.
Beekler's going to go on his feet. Apparently didn't think he was going to turn Raymond.
He didn't ride him for very long. And he didn't show a whole lot of promise getting away until the very end there.
Right,
so,
right.
This might be as good a place as any.
Strategically speaking, for
be
sure.
Be nice to see if Drew can get himself a takedown here.
One move ties it instead of needing two takedowns
right.
if you give up an escape.
And this is where Drew's
if he escapes, he needs a takedown anyway. So either way, he needs
correct.
One takedown. So
Drew's in a bit of a position of advantage here with a two-point lead. He doesn't have to be as aggressive as Beekler does here. And in the upper weights, sometimes that's an advantage. Drew just about got a nice go-behind takedown there because Beekler's got to put a little more risk out there now.
What Drew doesn't want to do is start waltzing too early and give up a stall.
No,
here.
Definitely not. It's way too early to give up the warning. Drew's got a little bit of blood.
Yeah.
So both guys are...
I would say this little respite in our match, both a chance to thank the Bulldog Nation Foundation and also a chance for Beekler to catch his win. This might be more to his advantage than
Drew's. It might be. I expect both guys to come out of here a little renewed fire.
Yeah, we'll get some strategies worked up. Now, again, we'll take a shout out to the Bulldog Nation Foundation, everything that they do for all of our activities here at PM. You happen to know the date on that facility's auction off the top of your head?
No.
Spring.
I'm going to say spring.
Yeah, if you get a chance to go to that, that's a good time. It's the money goes to a great cause. It all goes to the kids. Everything that happens And everything just gets sunk right back into the school. You cannot say enough good things about the Bulldog Nation Foundation.
Their organization's been just an absolute asset for PEM and PEM athletics. There's not an activity that we have that hasn't benefited from it. I think the mat we're looking at was purchased with funds from the Bulldog Nation Foundation.
That sounds correct. The equipment that we're using for this live stream was purchased by the Bulldog Nation Foundation. All right.
Good penetration. He had to take that risk at some point.
Drew should have maybe
stuffed that head a little harder on it. Again, Drew can burn a stall call here. He can burn two of them.
One thing Beekler is doing, you can tell he's tired. He's gone from his tie-ups. His hands are wider now than they were before. Early in the match when he was showing good promise on his feet, his stance was tight, his hips were low.
Drew's also doing a great job controlling the wrist, controlling the inside position.
There's a stall, inconsequential. Drew's going to win this one 2-0.
Token stall call. Good win for the young ninth grader.
Well, that brings us to the last match of the night. We're going to see Zeke Hines for the Panthers. And it sounds like, according to the youth wrestlers, it might be.
Sounds like Tony Roberton, I would say. Fruit salesman extraordinaire.
Yep, delivered my fruit just last night.
Century coming out with a lot of fire here. One thing Tony is pretty good at is slowing things down.
Tony will control the pace of the match to his advantage, that's for sure.
Mr. Bessie in the house.
Getting a shout out from Tony Roberton. I think it seems to be that Tony might be a youth wrestling crowd favorite. Is that safe to say?
I think that's safe to say. I know he's got at least one younger sibling in that youth crew. All right, Tony looking to work that underhook. Both guys in a bit of a feel it out mode right now.
Right, we saw that a little bit in the first period of the 220 match too for about the first minute. Little head slapping and neck rubbing.
Pretty early in the card game to put too many chips on the table, I'd say. I'm guessing April 9th might be the facilities auction.
Yeah, I just got a text from one of our super fans out there. April 9th is the Bulldog Nation Foundation facilities fundraiser, and your next Bulldog Nation Foundation live stream is going to be December 30th. We're going to have the dance competition right here in our gymnasium. I was trying to get head dance team coach Jen Simon up here for the Simon Report.
A little plug on the Simon Report.
But the gym has really been hopping tonight.
It has. Nice and loud.
Yep. We've had a lot of good action on the mat. Tony is going to take this match to the second period, 0-0. He defers.
All right, we're going down here. I would guess a wing roll is coming. What do you think of that prediction?
I would call it a bar roll.
A bar roll?
Wrong once again. Wing roll. I would say, probably pretty good chance of that.
Doesn't look like it. Looks like he's working
gonna
a stand-up.
Going to get a tripod to a stand-up. Going to drop that hip, see if Tony can elevate.
Tony got
to
get something.
They're out of bounds.
Pretty fortunate there.
Tony likes a 28-foot mat.
Yeah, the 28-foot mat works okay here.
At least on that particular go-around. Tony takes a left-handed start.
Pretty impressed with the pace this Zeke man Hines. From Century's bringing, Zeke.
Zeke Hines got a pretty good motor for a heavyweight.
Absolutely.
See if Tony can battle with it with his own pace here. Tony got a couple inches of height on him. If they decide to go upper body, that'll help Tony, but in the shot world, the lower man might Tony trying to get that front headlock.
And it's still just a 1-0 match. Obviously, Tony's expecting to get his escape in the next period. Time will tell how easy that is, how tough this Zeke is on top. But
I'm going to say this generationally. My body would not have withstood the retention of heat that long hair provides. Oh my God, that would have made me nuts.
It's jacked up. Yeah, that's a lot of hair out there. That is kind of a rule change in the last couple of years. We decided to quit caring about stuff that really didn't matter, like how long your hair was.
I don't have a problem with that at all, especially if it doesn't if it's not so long that it interferes with the match, let it roll. I'm just saying from a sheer body temperature maintenance.
Oh yeah. Well, it's acclimation, you know. It's like when you lived in Kuwait. You gotta get used to it.
I didn't have any hair when I lived there either. So.
No. Probably all wish right. You did back Tony, then.
Tony's going to take this match to the third period, down one.
Tony's doing a good job of working that underhook up.
I would assume Tony's going to go down.
Yeah, I'd be shocked if he did it.
We'll get an escape here, and then it'll be who can get a takedown. The Century Heavyweight seems to be not winded at all.
No, he's in great shape.
Yeah. Here comes
the adrenaline. Section. Yep, we got some canned adrenaline. Well, we got a wing roll, but it didn't quite
materialize.
Didn't quite get his body into
Tony,
a ball there.
Tony goes for the
he's
two.
He's gonna get his one.
He's gonna get his one right away.
And we're back to exciting finish here.
We're back to zeros
last match of the night.
And by zeros, I mean tied, 1-1. Each man with an escape. A couple of big horn sheep out there butting heads.
It's going to be an exciting finish for the big crowd here.
Yeah, it is.
I'm sure everybody, if you weren't a parent or a grandparent, didn't make yourself on the list last year. You didn't get to come to many events.
No, and then we got the good crowd tonight with the tackle cancer for Jordan Schumacher. We got the youth wrestlers here in force. We got all the teacher appreciation. Both these wrestlers are going to have to get on their ponies here with a minute to go.
Zeke looks like he's willing to take a little more risk. We'll see whether or not that's to his advantage or disadvantage down the stretch here.
Again, both these wrestlers appear to be about the same weight. Tony coming in at 249. Zeke stepping on the scale tonight at 251. So we are very evenly matched, these two guys.
Yes. A little bit of height differential, for sure.
Right, but I mean, as far as weight, we don't have one guy necessarily going to impose his will weight-wise on the other one.
Tony took a swing there at kind of an ill-advised headlock on the edge of the mat. I guess that was a good spot for it. Wasn't very tight. I think he would have been much better off taking it the other way. This could be good. This could be a go-around.
Might have bought Tony a little time in the world of a stalling call.
Yeah,
Zeke going to have to pull a string here. He's got 10 seconds left.
Tony's going to weather this storm.
Tony Robertson with the big win at 285, 58-21. The gym goes wild. Those heavyweights put on a pretty good show for only scoring 5 points. All right, it's pandemonium in the Bulldog Big House.
Bulldogs back in action at Eau Claire next week. I think Thursday of next week.
Yeah, and then we have our next live stream. I'm trying to catch Jen Simon's eye.
Get Jen for the Simon Report.
All right, so our next live stream that we're going to get here on the Bulldog Nation Foundation is going to be December 30th. We'll have the dance team live here And we're going to have a little bit of the Simon report. I don't know if we might.
We need a little sneak preview on what this dance event is going to entail.
We might get a little retro report on the state cross country if she's in the mood. But as the head dance team coach, not the head fan on the cross country, what do you got going on the 30th there, head coach Simon?
Well, we have a little smaller meet than we anticipated because we had a couple teams that disbanded this year in the area.
Disbanded, like they don't have a team anymore.
Correct.
That's kind of sad to hear.
It is very sad, actually. Our conference got a lot smaller. But, yeah, we have six very strong teams coming, and, yeah, between varsity and junior varsity. So some bigger schools, actually, with Winona and Byron joining us, and, yeah, some great high kick and jazz competition.
Any limit on your fan base this year with COVID?
If
people want to come and watch it live?
No, there is no limit. It starts at 6 p.m. on the 30th.
Who would be the favorite in this with these teams you have? Any state-ranked teams?
Is it kind of too early to tell?
Because even with us, we've only had one competition with some of that bad weather in there. They're all very good at this point, and I think probably a pretty even playing field at this point.
All right.
Yeah.
Sounds good.
That's
Thursday of next week.
That is Thursday of next
Thursday
week.
Thursday of next week. There's your Simon report. Don't forget to wear your Zestivus shirt tomorrow, head
that
coach.
That is correct. I have Zestivus already to go.
Happy Zestivus. All right, so we're going to give one big shout out back to the Bulldog Nation Foundation. And thanks for everybody that tuned in at home. I never saw what the actual number was. But we had a good time here in the gym, didn't we, Coach Marks?
I certainly did. It was nice to be back in the action again.
All right, so we're going to sign off, and we will...